Support for LAist comes from USC's renowned Gould School of Law. Earn your Master of Studies in Law, a law degree for any professional in every industry. Enhance your career credibility with an essential legal education. More at gould.law/MSL.
I'm Julia Paskin. Join me as I talk with NPR's Sarah McCammon about her new book, The Ex-Evangelicals, Loving, Living, and Leaving the White Evangelical Church. That's April 25th at the Crawford. Tickets at laist.com/events.
LAist Studios.
Today on the LA Report, an environmental advocacy group sues the federal government over its decision not to list the Joshua tree as an endangered or threatened species. The U.S. Supreme Court is set to hear a case that could affect the ability of Californians to access the abortion pill. And a Los Angeles book publisher with deep local roots is revived under new ownership.
Angel City Press is both a small business, but it's also a very loved and cherished institution within Los Angeles.
Good morning. It's Monday, March 25th. I'm Suzanne Whatley, and you're listening to the LA Report from LAist 89.3. Environmental advocates are suing the federal government for its decision not to list the Joshua tree under the Endangered Species Act. Lindsay Laris is an attorney with Wild Earth Guardians. She says the listing of the iconic tree, which is under threat by climate change, would allow for more protections.
Doing that would enable the federal government to designate money towards doing things like wildfire mitigation, which could be something as simple as getting rid of those invasive plants that cause wildfires to spread.
Now, this is the second time the group is suing the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service over Joshua tree protections. The agency says it does not comment on pending litigation. The United States Supreme Court is set to hear a case that could limit access to the abortion pill. LAist senior health reporter Jackie Fortier says the hearing is set for tomorrow.
A case that could limit access to the abortion pill will be heard by the U.S. Supreme Court. Anti-abortion rights groups sued the Food and Drug Administration over rules that expanded access to the abortion pill mifepristone. The drug is approved for use up to around 10 weeks of pregnancy, though the court could roll that back to 7 weeks and require an in-person visit with a doctor. Those restrictions could affect millions of Californians, said Amanda Barrow with UCLA Law.
It could result in decreased access for rural and underserved communities here in California. It could also result in an overburdened healthcare system in the state.
The Supreme Court's decision will be announced this summer. I'm Jackie Fortier.
California's largest private insurance provider says it will not renew around 72,000 homeowners policies in the state. State Farm says this includes houses, condos, and apartments beginning July 3rd. Recently, the company raised California homeowner insurance rates by 20%. The company has not issued new insurance policies since 2022. State Farm says its decision was driven by inflation, catastrophe exposure, and other factors. You can read more about it online at laist.com. Happening today, Metrolink and Amtrak trains resume full service through South Orange County after 2 months of emergency construction to build a catchment wall in San Clemente. Scott Johnson with Metrolink says in addition to the wall, they are looking for other solutions to avoid future shutdowns in coming decades.
These walls are simply to provide a barrier between the soil and debris and the right-of-way. They do little to actually stop or prevent any type of movement or falling debris.
The Orange County Transportation Authority is now conducting studies on the future of the rail line. For Amtrak, the route is a portion of its second busiest corridor in the U.S., with yearly ridership of 3 million passengers. A public comment meeting will be held April 11th. Coming up, a downtown Los Angeles nightclub that hosted some greats in Latin music is set to close.
Support for LAist comes from USC Gould School of Law, the first law school in Southern California, renowned for its history of excellence and innovation. Elevate your career with our Master of Studies in Law, a versatile degree for professionals in every industry. With online, on-campus, and hybrid formats, USC Gould offers flexibility to fit your schedule. Specialize in areas like business, entertainment, HR, healthcare, compliance, finance, and cybersecurity. Learn more at gould.law/MSL.
Imagine if you could charge your electric vehicle at the places you already love to eat, shop, and play. Whether you're at the movies, on your weekly grocery trip, or running errands at your local mall, Volta EV charging stations are built around your day-to-day and located in your community and nationwide. All you have to do is check in, plug in, and go about your day. It's EV charging made convenient. Download the Volta app to find your new favorite place to charge.
Back now to the LA Report. A small publishing house focused on telling Southern California stories has a new home. Angel City Press was donated to the Los Angeles Public Library last December. The operation was founded in 1992 and has produced more than 135 titles spanning the history of the West. City librarian John Szabo says the focus will remain on telling unique LA stories.
Angel City Press is both a small business, but it's also a very loved and cherished institution within Los Angeles.
The library now owns the fully operational book publisher and its inventory of titles. The contracts with numerous Los Angeles-based authors have also been preserved. The curtain is coming down on a legendary nightclub in downtown Los Angeles. That's legendary Cuban singer Celia Cruz. She performed at the Conga Room on opening night back in 1998. Tito Puente, Sheila E., and even Bad Bunny performed at the LA nightclub, but this week the Conga Room closes its doors. Owner Brad Gluckstein points to the pandemic and competition from concert giants such as AEG as some of the reasons why. But in the 25 years it was open, actor Jimmy Smits says the Conga Room made a big mark on LA's music scene.
You got 1,100 people in a room listening to some beautiful Latin sounds. You know, it's going to be more than lively.
Smits was one of the Conga Room's original investors and spoke with our How to LA podcast. Hear more in today's episode at laist.com/howtoLA. Our first spring storm is moving on, clearing the way for a dry week before heavier rainfall returns next weekend. From the beaches to the coastal valleys into the Inland Empire, it'll be mostly sunny with highs in the 60s. And in the Coachella Valley this afternoon, it'll be warm and windy with highs from 75 to 80 degrees. Thank you for listening to the LA Report. You can read more news at laist.com or listen live anytime on the LAist app or on the radio at 89.3 FM. The AM edition is hosted and produced by me, Suzanne Whatley, with assistance from producer Tyler Wayne. Our engineer is Federico Garcia Rodriguez. Catherine Mailhouse is the director of content development. LAist's executive editor is Megan Garvey, original music by Scott Kelly. Check back here at 4 for the PM edition. Listeners like you help make the LA Report possible. Please donate at laist.com/join. And the LA Report is supported by Gordon and Donna Crawford, who believe quality journalism makes Southern California a better place to live.
I'm Julia Paskin, host of Weekend Edition. Join me as I talk with NPR's Sarah McCammon about her new book, The Ex-Evangelicals, Loving, Living, and Leaving the White Evangelical Church. She's not alone in leaving the church. She's found she's among a rising generation fleeing the fold. That's April 25th at the Crawford in Pasadena. Tickets at laist.com/events.